Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about the new Project Online Service roadmap and the features within it. So let's head over to Project Home. Now, roadmap has not been deployed to all tenants just yet, but if you click on create new, you might see the new button called roadmap. And if we click on this, we're taking over to the roadmap area. From here, we can give our roadmap a name and we can assign an owner to it. And when we've done this, we can click on add row. And we can choose to just create a blank one, or we can choose to connect it to a project within Project Online. So here I'm connecting it to the project Doofy Dunes. And it's going to show me what it's going to do. It's going to create a flow for me within Microsoft Flow. And it's going to make a one-way connection from Project Online to Roadmap. So whenever anything updates in Project Online, our Roadmap will be updated accordingly. So let's connect it. It will just take a minute. And now we can start to add items. Let's add a couple of items. Now I can add anything from a task to a milestone to a phase. Let's just go to the project to see how it looks. It had a lot of phases. It has a lot of milestones and tasks. Let's add the phases as this is the overall view we want to track from the roadmap area. So just like that, we added a couple of phases and the milestone. Let's just get rid of that. And let's add a couple of more phases. That's it. So we have all the faces we want to. We will now in a second see them displayed within the roadmap area as a Gantt chart. Let's just zoom out a little bit. Here we can see everything and scroll to the right area. You can see now that all the faces that we just added are available. And we can track them from here. So now when anything updates in Project Online, we will see our faces updating accordingly. And also set a status on these faces, how we are viewing them. If something is at risk, if something is done, if something is critical, we can mark it to remind us later that this is something we have to keep track on and be aware of. And the next thing we're going to do is let's just add a key date. Let's add a go live date. So we remind ourselves, well, this is the go live date for not just the Doofy Dunes projects, but also for projects from Azure or anything, Azure DevOps or anywhere else. So just set this to September in 2019. And we can see we have a key date here. Where everything should be finished, or at least we should be ready for go live. Next, let's look into Azure DevOps, because we can connect our roadmap projects to Project Online. We can also connect them to DevOps. So let's start by connecting a new project. And here we're going to take this one. And again, it's going to ask us, well, do we want to create a flow based on this? And yes, we do. We want to create a flow with a one-way connection from Azure to Roadmap. Next, let's go into Azure and see what kind of tasks we have in the sprint and see what we can add within the roadmap. So let's just add a couple of items and we can search for the login and logout features, tasks, and add them to our roadmap. That's it. Let's add them. And now if we scroll out, we can see the new tasks have been added to roadmap. We can see one task take a significant amount of time. The two other tasks doesn't really take any time, which is kind of, strange, except maybe the metadata wasn't updated in Azure. Just add owners to these two projects so we remember who is actually responsible for them. And if we click on the Azure project and go over here to Azure DevOps. And the work items, we can see here that we have a start date and we have a target date. These are the two dates that controls the view in roadmap. Let's just change the target date. And let's take the other work item. And we don't actually have a start date or a target date. So in this case, roadmap just chose the current date, which obviously isn't what we expect. So let's just add a period to it. So back in roadmap, we can go in here, we can click on update. And this update is going to take anywhere between 15 seconds and 5 minutes. But a short while will be done like that. And we just need to click on the screen. And then the tasks are updated. We can do the same thing with the project. Go in here, just for the fun of it, change a couple of dates. And after that, go in and update it and see these dates being updated in Project Online. That's it. Let's update the project and just fast forward. And that's it. Now the project is updated and we can see the new dates in here. We can also share the roadmap with other colleagues. When we share it, it will be available from their project home. So when they go to project home, they will see this roadmap and be able to access it and presumably also change it. So let's add a couple of members here. And it's easier searching out their name and just click on them. And then it is shared. This was some of the key functionality of roadmap. Of course, there was also other features I didn't talk about. And you should also notice this is still an early version. Might come more functionality before we see it on all tenants. But it will be deployed soon to all tenants. So keep an eye out for it. And I hope you will enjoy it. Now, when we have all our data within roadmap, we can also extract this data in Power BI or any other reporting tool. Extracted into Power BI, it could look like this. Here we have all our roadmaps. We have the counts between what we have in Azure and what we have in project. We have the Gantt chart below, and we can slice and dice and filter it as we like. If we look into flow, we will also see some new flows have been created for us. We can see here there is a flow for each project that is connected to either Project Online or to Azure DevOps. And we can even go in and modify this flow if we like to. For example, if we don't want it to use the target date in Azure DevOps or we want to use the due date instead, we can go in and change that. Though I would be advise people to be cautious about doing this. I haven't tried it myself just yet. And it is the internal workings of roadmap. I'm not sure if Microsoft is going to block our access to this in the future. They might do it. But for now, I will at least try to see what happens when we modify this flow. This was everything from me. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope to see you in the next one.